Hello students, today we will read part 2 of two stories about flying, that is The Black Aeroplane, which is written by Frederick Forsyth, an English author and journalist who is born on 25th August 1938 in the United Kingdom. Some of his notable works are The Day of the Jackal, The Devil's Alternative, The Dogs of War, The Cobra and The Kill List. So, before proceeding to the chapter, let me tell you the theme of this chapter. This story is based on the experience of the author Frederick, and this story highlights the importance of independence, self-belief and courage. Besides, also in this that chapter, the author wants to tell that our conscience is our best supporter, which helps us to overcome any kind of difficulty. So let's read the chapter, The Black Aeroplane. The moon was coming up in the east behind me, and the stars are shining in the clear sky above me. So who is referred to me here? The author himself. So this sentence tells that the sky is clear. There was not a cloud in the sky. I was happy to be alone high up above the sleeping countryside. And the author is very happy that he is in high up above. Means that time he was flying a Dakota aeroplane. I was flying my old Dakota aeroplane, that is one type of a military aircraft. And he was flying that, and he was going from France to England. I was dreaming of my holiday and looking forward to being with my family. So he was going to England to meet his family. I looked at my watch, 1:30 in the morning. I should call Paris control room, I thought. Then I switched on the radio and said, Paris control, Dakota DS-088, that is the number of that aircraft. Can you hear me? I am on my way to England. Over. The voice from the radio answered, and yes, DS-088, I can hear you. But it was a reply from the Paris control room. You ought to turn 12 degrees west now, DS-088, over. So the author got a reply from the control room. I checked the map and the compass and switched over to my second and the last fuel tank and turned the Dakota 12 degrees west towards England. So everything was going on well. It was an easy flight, so he was flying in the sky, and the sky was very clear, and it was a good experience flying the Dakota. Paris was about 150 kilometers behind me when I saw the clouds. But suddenly there is a twist in this story. What happened? So suddenly he marked Dakota straight into the storm. So see children, this line is very important. So he felt a difficulty that he cannot go to England because there is less amount of fuel in the fuel tank, and there are so many cloud storms in front of him, like black mountains, he decided that he will not go back to England, and he will not go back to Paris. He will go to London to meet his family. So that's why he said that I will take the risk. So inside the clouds, everything was suddenly black. It was impossible to see anything outside the aeroplane. The old aeroplane jumped and twisted in the air. So he was now he was in a great difficulty that how the it was the great storm and he was unable to fly his Dakota, and he saw, he marked that player, Dakota was moving twist it was moving around and it was jumped and twisted. And I looked at the compass. I could not believe my eyes. The compass was turning round and round and round. Means the compass was dead. It was inactive. It was not functioning at all. So it would not work. The other instruments were suddenly also dead too. I tried the radio. So he was in such a great difficulty that less amount of fuel, at the same time compass was dead. Then he started tried to contact with the control room. So Paris control, can you hear me? So there was no answer. The radio was also dead. So see the great difficulty he was in a great difficulty situation. The radio was also dead too. I had no radio, no compass, and I could not see where I was. I was lost in the storm. Then in the black clouds quite near me, I saw another aeroplane. So suddenly he was in a great difficulty, and suddenly he felt that there is another aeroplane. It had no lights, and that aeroplane had no lights on its wings, but I could see it flying next to me through the storm. But he marked that aeroplane was flying just nearby his Dakota. I could see the pilot's face turned towards me. I was very glad to see another person. He lifted one hand and waved, and he felt that the pilot who was in that aeroplane, he was trying to help me. Follow me, he was saying, follow me. He knows that I am lost. I thought he was trying to help me. He turned his aeroplane slowly to the north in front of my Dakota so that it would be easier for me to follow him. So I was very happy to go behind. So the pilot came with his aeroplane, and he was just giving signal to the author that to follow him, and he also did it. I was very happy to go behind him, behind the strange aeroplane, like an obedient child. So he followed that aeroplane like an obedient child. After half an hour, the strange black aeroplane was still there in front of me in the clouds. Now, then again, it was an airport. I was safe. I turned to look for my friend in the black aeroplane. So finally he reached to the aeroplane. He reached to the airport. But when he looked back to see that the pilot who was in the aeroplane, who helped him in the sky, but he did not find anybody. I turned to look for my friend in the black aeroplane, but the sky was empty. There was nothing, no one there. The black aeroplane was gone. I could not see it anymore. So he tried his best to meet that person that who helped him in his great situation. Then I landed and was not sorry to walk away from my old Dakota near the control tower. I went and asked the man. Then he reached to the airport, and he went directly to the control room, and he asked the woman who was in the control room that where I was and the other two pilot was. I wanted to say thank you. So he asked to the woman who was in the control room that I want to meet that person who was in the who was the pilot of that aeroplane and who helped me a lot in my great difficulty, and I want to tell him thank you. I want to say him thank you. Then the woman looked at the authors very strangely and then laughed. Why? Then another aeroplane up there in this storm. Who said? The woman in the control room. The another aeroplane up there in the storm. No, other aeroplanes were flying tonight. Only yours was the only one I could see on the radar. So the woman in the duty, she told that there was no other aeroplane and it was only your aeroplane which was flying today, and she could see in the on the radar. So he got very confused, and how come that person was there in the aeroplane and who helped him? He got very confused. So who helped me to arrive there safely without compass or a radio or without any more fuel in my tanks? Who was the pilot on the strange black aeroplane flying in the storm without lights? So see children, the story ends with so many questions by the author. That how he got confused that who helped him, who was the pilot, and where did the pilot go. So he asked so many questions to him. So can you guess that who was the pilot and who helped him in his great difficult situation? Can you children? So it was actually his own conscience, yourself only. So the message of the story is that always trust on your own capability, own potential, self belief, self courage. So if you have self belief, potential, you can only you, it is you.